It's the end of the world, and I feel fine. How about you? Well, I feel fine because it's not the end of the world. It's business as usual, which is exactly what I said was going to happen. And the last week or so, I've been doing some debunking videos, as many of you are aware, talking about Friedrich Merz's speech, where he misspoke and said September instead of February, and people just couldn't get their minds around that. Look at the comment section in that video. People are nuts. Or The Simpsons. The Simpsons now are predicting for you the future. September 24th. Oh, but on The Simpsons it said blah, blah, blah. And what? September 24th came and went. Nothing happened. And as alluded to on the last video, the one where I was talking about The Simpsons, and I probably need to do an expanded video on that because of where are you people getting this information from? The things that people were saying in the comment section, it just makes no sense. I had said on the 25th, which is today, I would do one of two things. I would A, either apologize for being wrong, or B, rub your face in it. Well, I'm not gonna really rub your face in it. I'm not gonna be a prick about it. You know, I told you so, nah. But basically, have you not learned your lesson? Let me just ask you a question. If you're one of those people that got angry at me and tried to make all these excuses, which made no sense. The one that really jumps out at me is the one where it's like, well, then why did all the Jews leave New York City? They didn't leave New York City. You know that New York City, the Jewish population makes up about 12% of the people there. Right? 12% of the population of New York City is Hebrew people. They're traditional Jews. So I think if 12% of New York City just up and packed their bags and disappeared, you would have heard about it. All right? They did not leave New York because they got wind of a dirty bomb that's supposed to go off when? September 24th. Didn't happen. Didn't happen. A lot of things did not happen, and I'm like, where are these people hearing this stuff? Which is why I've been doing the debunking videos here recently, just to get people to slow down and think. Again, I want you to prep. Really, I do. I want you to prep, but I want you to be smart about it and quit trying to date set and quit falling for it. A lot of prepper channels are doing it. A lot of prophecy channels are doing it, which I find very insulting, especially when I see a so-called Christian channel doing it and how many people buy into what they say. Bible tells you not to do that. Don't listen to diviners. Don't listen to fortune tellers. Don't listen to necromancers. And what does it say? I think it's Matthew. You shall not know the day or the hour, right? You're not going to know. Be ready for it. But you don't know when it's going to happen. Quit trying to predict it. Quit assuming that every number that comes down the pike, because this cycles through every few years, is something comes up. But in recent years, it's been accelerating, and we get more and more of it, especially with the internet and especially with social media, because a lot of these people, and this is what's happened to those prepper channels, because I did have a lot of people in the comment section also. They weren't all crazy comments. A lot of people were like, hey, thank you for doing this logically and walking us through some of this, because there are people that need to hear it. That's true. Another comment that I was getting a lot of was, you know, I used to watch this prepper channel or that one, and they've gotten on this big doom and gloom bandwagon. What the hell is the deal? The deal is ad revenue. That sells. Those videos where they say, oh, I can predict the end of the world, and oh, this is going to happen, and you better be ready. Those videos get a lot of views, and that's a lot of money for those guys, is what it is. It's a way for them to get better earnings. So they've sold out, essentially. Without calling out any names, you know, I'm sure you can figure it out for yourself, but without calling out any names, they're selling out. The other one that killed me was how people kept saying, well, when Merz said it, that everybody was in agreement. And they weren't in agreement. They were wondering why the hell he said September. And when they were muttering after he said September 24th, everybody was like, what the hell? What is he talking about? Because he said the date wrong. But he's timed. He's got to keep going. You know, he's only got so much time on the podium, and he's got to move. So he kept going, which is what you do. Also, speaking in past tense, oh, we will remember. So, that wouldn't make sense if he said September 24th? in the future, we will remember September 24th. That makes sense, grammatically speaking. So he misspeaks and says September 24th, and it's also sounds like it's past tense. It works for both sentences, future past tense for the February 24th date. But people just, you know, they won't let their minds absorb that, and they want to argue about it. Well, there's nothing left to argue about because September 24th was yesterday. And please don't tell me that they really meant to say 2023, okay? Because I know it's coming. The Simpsons, and this is where you're going to hear it too. And I should do a whole thing on The Simpsons because it's amazing to me how much people don't understand about that. And I get people in the comments on that one. Oh, you don't understand. They've predicted over 100 things, and they predicted hundreds of things, and they're so accurate. And I looked it up. Did you? They didn't predict shit. All right? They really haven't. There's like 20 things out of there's been, what, between 700 and 800 episodes? And I know there's the whole predictive programming thing, and that's another boogeyman. And I should probably do a video on that too. Do you want to see videos on this while I'm on this trip right now? Because really, I just want people to slow down and think. Again, please do prep. You should have a pantry. You should have a way to defend yourself. You should have a way to purify water, and you should have water put up. You should have some training and some skills, you know? And there's nothing wrong with knowing what's going on in the world around you. But you can't just fall into a ditch with everything that comes along and be like, oh my God, this is it. Oh my God, this is it. And then it isn't. And you're on a roller coaster of emotion constantly, of fear and relief, fear and relief. It's toxic. Don't do that to yourself. Don't do that to yourself. Especially so-called Christians. You guys drive me nuts with that stuff. Or the Red Heifer Prophecy one. Man, I got slammed on the Red Heifer Prophecy video that I put out. Because so what? They found another red heifer. You know how many times that's happened? And I demonstrate that in the video. They find them all the time. And so what? There's no temple. There's no Cohens, a Jewish priest. Somebody got mad at me because I didn't say Cohen in one of the videos. And I'm like, hey, I'm having a hard enough time explaining this. you want me to do biblical definitions too? I'm trying here. I'm just trying to put out a quick video and just reach people and get to the point. The other one on The Simpsons, again, predicting over 100 things or predicting hundreds of things. It's like 20. It's like 20, and they're loosely associated. You could make it fit or not. Kind of like the Nostradamus predictions. A handful of like vague quatrains that were written over 500 years ago. You know, in 500 years, eventually something is going to happen that feels like it might fit. Prediction. It doesn't mean he predicted anything. And people still fall for it. But I just wanted to put that out there. So, yeah, I'm not really rubbing your face in it. I'm just asking you, please slow down next time. Slow down. Think about it. Use your common sense. Use a little bit of logic. If I can look this stuff up, so can you. Okay? Are you sitting in front of the computer? An argument I make all the time. And by the way, if you missed the live stream, that's because it was on my other channel, Coffee Talk. Coffee Talk. I have two channels, and that's where the live stream is. So please slow down. Please take a breath. Please do be prepared, but be smart about it. Don't believe everything that you hear. And especially you guys who claim to be Christians, actually study the Bible. Don't just read Paul and ignore everything else that's in there. And do try to understand what's in it, because I know it's hard to put it in proper context, because what words mean to us now and what they meant back then are different. So you really have to honestly study it and look at the language and look at the culture of the time period to really understand. Just a quick explanation of that. For example, in modern times, the terms love and hate, or the words love and hate, have an emotional connotation. So you love something or you hate something, it's emotional. At the time period that the Bible was written, love and hate had utilitarian functions. Love meant to be dedicated to something and required action. to hate something meant to reject it. So it had a function. It wasn't an emotion. And when you read the Bible with that type of understanding, it changes what you're reading quite a bit. Think about it. Stop date setting. The Bible says don't do that. No more date setting. Throw away those tarot cards. Throw away that Uno deck. Who is it? There's some church that does that. I'm going to teach myself to be prophetic by playing Uno. Like you can force the Holy Spirit to do something. Get rid of the Ouija board or whatever else you're doing, because it's restricted. The Bible doesn't like that. God does not like that. Yehovah or Jehovah, depending upon your pronunciation. Anyway, not trying to turn it into a Bible study, but you get the point. You're all still here. I'm still here. Calm down. Prep, as always. Be smart about it. And I guess I've said more than enough. If you have any thoughts, feel free to put your thoughts in the comment section down below. What do you think about all of that? What do you think about all that? And do you want me to continue for another week or two with the debunking of some of these concepts, like The Simpsons and like predictive programming and things like that? Let me know. If you saw random cat images, they are strays that my wife and I take care of, and pictures of them in the video help with YouTube's loading algorithm, believe it or not. YouTube likes cat channels. They hate channels like this, but they love cats. If you wanted to help the channel out, there are links for that down below. Every little bit helps, and we sure do appreciate it. And if that's it, then what more can I say but stay frosty, folks, and thanks for watching.